Welcome to this advanced demo series where you're going to be migrating a simple web application from an on-premises environment into AWS. The on-premises environment is a virtual web server simulated using EC2 and a self-managed MariaDB database server also simulated via EC2. Now you're going to be migrating this into AWS and running the architecture on an EC2 web server together with an RDS managed SQL database, and you'll be performing this migration using the Database Migration Service, or DMS, from AWS. Now this is the architecture explaining the whole process. On the left we have the two virtual machines, CatWeb and CatDB, and this is a simulated on-premises environment. So this is the type of environment which you might have on-premises and you're looking to migrate into AWS. On the right we have the AWS environment, so you're going to be provisioning an EC2 based web server and an RDS instance to store the database, and then you'll be copying the content over using SSH and using the Database Migration Service to perform a synchronization of the data from the source to the destination. Now don't worry if this looks overly complicated, because you're going to be performing it step by step and I'll be here every step of the way to help. Now, stage one of this demo series is to implement the base infrastructure. So this is implementing the simulated on-premises environment on the left and the base AWS infrastructure on the right. Now, to deploy this infrastructure, you'll be using a one-click deployment, and the link to do that is attached both to this lesson and the lesson series text instructions, and they're also linked attached to this lesson. And I do recommend that you open up the text instructions for each stage of this demo series, because they'll contain the commands and the individual steps that you'll be using at every point in the series. Now to get started, we'll be switching over to an AWS account, so let's go ahead and do that. Now to get started, just make sure that you're logged into an AWS account using an IAM user which has admin permissions, and also make sure that you have the Northern Virginia region selected. This is usually the default, but for this advanced demo series it's essential, because the AMIs that you'll be using to deploy the base infrastructure are only stored in US East 1. So once you're logged into an account and have the Northern Virginia region selected, there's a one-click deployment link which is attached to this lesson. Go ahead and open that in your browser, and you'll be taken to the Quick Create Stack screen, where the stack name and all of the parameter values will be pre-populated with appropriate defaults. All you'll need to do is to scroll down and just take note of all of these parameter values, because you'll be using them later in the demo series. So specifically the DB name, the DB password, the DB root password, and the DB user. So once you've noted those down, you just need to scroll down to the bottom and check the Acknowledge Capabilities box, and then click on Create Stack. So this is going to create the base infrastructure for this advanced demo series. Now we're going to need this stack to be in the create complete state before we continue. So go ahead and pause the video, wait for your stack to change into create complete, and then we can resume. Okay, so now your stack's in a create complete status, you've actually implemented the architecture that's on screen now. So you have the simulated on-premises environment on the left and the base AWS infrastructure on the right. What you need to do before you finish up with this stage of the advanced demo is just to verify that the infrastructure is functioning as expected. So to do that, click on the services drop-down at the top of the screen and just type EC2 into this Find Services box, and then click to move to the EC2 console. Now, depending on when you're doing this demo lesson, the user interface for EC2 might look a little bit different. It's functionally the same, but AWS are in the process of updating various parts of the interface, and I'm using an account which specifically has the new version of this interface. So go ahead and click on Running Instances. You'll see that you've got two instances, CatWeb and CatDB. CatWeb is the simulated virtual machine web server, and CatDB is the simulated virtual machine self-managed database. So go ahead and select CatWeb, And then down at the bottom, you're looking for the public IP version 4 DNS address. Go ahead and copy that into your clipboard and then open that in a new tab. If everything's working as expected, you should see the Animals for Life Hall of Fame. It should have Patches the Wonder Cat at the top. Scrolling down, you should see the chickens, and then right down at the bottom are my four cats, Winky, Truffles, Ruffle, and Penny. And if you see all of those, it means the demo base infrastructure has deployed successfully. Now, at this point, that's everything that you need to do in stage one of this advanced demo. In stage two of this advanced demo series, you're going to be provisioning connectivity between the simulated on-premises environment on the left and the AWS environment on the right. Now, in production, you'd probably be using a VPN or a Direct Connect. In this demo series, you're going to be simulating this by using a VPC peer. So that's what you'll be configuring in stage two. Now that's everything you need to do in stage one, so go ahead, complete the video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in the next.